Hello everyone.
Welcome back to our session all together.
How was your break?
Was your break fun or not?
Anyway, I hope that you enjoyed your new break and the break was fun. So now let's move to our session all together that we focus on hangout for today. So hangout for, we still continue with unit 2, follow the rules, right? So today we focus on the grammar point. So the grammar point about the modal verb must. So how to use modal verb must? So you might learn some of modal verb already, right? Like can, like to, and so on. So must here is used to express. We have one more word too. So used to express obligation. Obligation, we refer to your duty. Your duty, what you have to do, what you have not do. So we call obligation, give orders, and give advice. So give advice is mean that you just tell someone about something, but he or she might follow you or not. You don't know, because just give them the advice. You just suggest them, right? Advice, it seems like you just give your own opinion, your own idea in order to correct his or her mistakes. And give orders when you ask someone to do something. So now let's go to our form together. Today I would like to take you to form. Affirmative form. Subject plus must plus verb base here. Subject plus must plus verb base blah blah blah. Verb base here, we refer to verb that never change form, with every situation. We call verb base. And some might call verb zero, but actually we call verb base, right? So subject plus must plus verb base. Again, verb base, we refer to the verb that never change form in every situation, in every form. Blah, blah, blah. Example, you must listen to the librarian. You must listen to the librarian. Look at here. This sentence is about your obligation, give orders, and or give advice. What is it? So, it is about obligation. Why did you say obligation? Because about what you have to do and must not do in the library is the rule, right? So you can say obligation or advise someone. Is it right? All right, so is it follow from our form? You plus must, so you is subject, and then plus modal verb plus verb base here. You can see? All right. She must turn off her phone. You have learned about subject with verb 3 or with verb already, right? So when subject you when verb used with third person singular like he, she, it, verb must add S. Is it right? But here, why don't we add any S? Because we have must here, that is why we don't add S with verb here. And verb, that's why we call this one as a verb base. Because it doesn't change form. Is it right? Again, subject plus must plus verb base. She is third person singular, but we don't add S with the word must or turn, because must is a modal verb, that's why we don't add S. And turn here, we use as what? As the verb base, because we have modal verb here. You can see? All right, even third person, but verb still verb base. So she must turn off her phone. She must turn off her phone. Number three, you must wear headphones in the library. This is about you have to give someone advice, right? All right, and then 4, 5, 6, you can give it by your own self. Now let's go to negative form. Subject plus must plus not plus verb base. So in the negative form, you just use not between must and verb base only is enough, and then it become negative form. They must not go out. They must not go out. And some might ask you, teacher, do we have any short form of must not? No, we don't have any short form of must not. So you can say they must not use must and then have apostrophe, no, you write that's a long form. They must not go out. Number two, he must not sit on a desk. He must not sit on a desk. So this is about what you give someone advice. Because he or she can sit on her own desk. But if you don't want he or she sit on it, you see this as a mistake, so you can give him her advice that he must not sit on a desk. Now let's go to number three. You must shout here. You must or must not. Should be have not, right? You forgot not. So you must not shout here because here doesn't allow you to shout like in the library, like in the class during the lesson session and so on. Alright everyone, so hopefully you can understand how to use must. Now I would like to sum up about some point for you. Again, so must be used with verb base. Even third person singular, we don't have to add any S. ES change Y to IS with verb because we use verb as the verb base. Verb base will refer for verb that never change form. But what you mean? You might say that, teacher, this is verb one. Why you call verb base? Why I call verb base? Because if it is verb one, why don't you add S with third person singular? That's why we call this one as verb base, not verb one. But you can see that it's the same as the verb one. Is it right? Yes, but actually we call it as a verb base because it doesn't change form. That's why we call verb base. But if you call verb one, you have to change form when you use with third person singular. Got what you mean? Alright. So and then negative form you just use not between must and verb base only is enough. Alright everyone, hopefully you can understand, but if there's any question related to our hangout today about the grammar mode of must, you can ask your home teacher for more detail. So goodbye everyone, see you tomorrow and have a nice day. Good luck.